Hey guys, welcome back. Today's Thursday, May 25th, and it's the 40th anniversary of Star Wars. On Memorial Day weekend, 1977, a little film called Star Wars burst into a very, very limited showing on screens across the U.S. It soon became a hit and broke all sorts of records, some of which still stand today. Since then, it has spawned countless books, countless TV references, 4 sequel films, 3 prequel films, 2 standalone anthology films, I'm counting the Han Solo one that hasn't come out yet, 5 animated series, and 2 TV movies. It is, without a doubt, the most successful film series of all time. Again, I am so sorry for not talking about this anymore in the weeks leading up to it. I had hoped to have just a little snippet of my film reenactments done by now, but as they say, the best laid plans of mice and men, or would that be the best laid plans of Minox and Jedi? Doesn't have the same ring to it. But I've got a lot planned for today. I'm not going to be able to do as much as I had planned originally, but I'm hoping you'll still have a lot of fun as you come along with me. Among other things, I'm going to be reacting to videos that were shot back at Celebration 4 in 2007, which is 10 years ago. Of course, drawing a picture to honor the 40th anniversary, painting the Rebel symbol on my new costume bag that I'm going to be taking my costumes in to the Star Wars Reads event on Saturday, and of course, watching Star Wars, in my case, if possible, the original VHS tape of A New Hope, which you saw when I showed you my Star Wars collection. As you can see, I'm sporting the Leia buns again, and today is hardly the end of it. This entire weekend through next Tuesday is going to be loaded with a whole bunch of stuff, both Star Wars stuff and other stuff, because my friend Gulfstream69 is flying out tomorrow. Woohoo! I cannot wait. So without further ado, let's get started.
Yeah, so what I decided to start with today was painting the Rebel symbol onto the top of this bag. This is going to be the rolling bag that I'm going to keep all my costume stuff in when I troop from now on, because it's a good size and I can keep everything organized in there, and that means just dragging around one bag instead of struggling with the backpack and one or two other bags.
I've got an outline right there on my computer to look at for reference. And since I'm not very good at freehanding stuff, I'm going to sketch the outline first with a piece of chalk and then paint around it with this paint, this blue paint, and then fill it in. So let's get started.
Judging by the paint on my hands, would you think that I'm done? You would be right. There it is. The Rebel Alliance. Some people call it Phoenix symbol. The white chalk marks I can wipe off with a damp cloth later after this dries, but this has to dry flat for four hours.
I'm gonna watch my
Celebration 4 highlight video that I made now.
Of reason and regret, so I will not forget. I will not forget how this felt 1 year, 6 months ago. I know I cannot forget. I cannot forget. I'm falling into memories of you. Just forget. Being on this road is anything but sure. Maybe we'll forget. I hope we don't forget. I'm falling into memories of you.
That one made me a little misty-eyed because most of the people I met there, I haven't seen since. And I miss everybody. Well, hopefully someday I can go back to a celebration and see some of them again. Okay, the paint's dry and I've added a couple of extra patches to my bag. Oh, also, in case you didn't notice, yes, my regular camera is done charging. So this is the finished product. Look at this. See, I've got an X-Wing patch, Jedi assembly patch, of course the large Rebel symbol, and a patch for Sunrider base, which is the region of Rebel Legion that I'm a member of. Well, it's pretty quiet.
I think it's time for some fan art.
Okay, guys, finally, here's the finished product. That iconic opening shot from episode 4, which is 40 years old today. I think I did pretty good on Tatooine, but the Star Destroyer could have been a little bit better. I had to explain to my mom what it was. But there you go. There's my fan art. I've got only two more things to do before the end of the evening, but I want to do them soon so I can wrap this thing up and then start editing and get the whole thing edited before tomorrow. Because tomorrow I'm not going to have time for anything else. Okay, guys, so I'm finishing off the day with some blue milk. Blue almond milk, technically. And briefly, I'm going to talk about what my life would be like without Star Wars. If it wasn't for Star Wars, I would definitely have fewer friends. I was always the weird girl growing up, and not just because I love Star Wars. I was always sort of a social pariah, almost like an outcast, because I was the only kid. Me and my siblings were the only people in church that were homeschooled. I know without Star Wars, I would have less confidence. Because, like I said, growing up, I was something of a social outcast and also painfully shy. Without Star Wars, I would probably never dress up and wear a costume when it's not Halloween, especially not in public, because I'm so self-conscious and nervous. Without trooping with the Rebel Legion, I'd probably never do that if there was no Star Wars. Star Wars also impacted my creativity. If I'd never seen it or if it didn't exist, I might never have published any books. I would probably not be inspired to shoot short films because it was watching the special features for Star Wars that made me want to do that. And I definitely would never have started a YouTube channel. So it's safe to say Star Wars made a big impact in my life, and without it, my life would be extremely different and probably more empty. So guys, how has Star Wars impacted your life? How would your life be different without Star Wars? I mean, without Star Wars, where do you think you'd be? How much has it impacted you? Like, socially, emotionally, any way it's impacted you. How has it done that, and how would your life be different without it? Go ahead, post it below. I look forward to seeing your responses. Well, guys, that's about it. I'm going to finish up in a few minutes by watching Star Wars A New Hope. After I put the dogs to bed, of course. Tomorrow, I'm going to have as many things as I can uploaded. I don't know if I'm going to be able to do this one. I'm probably going to have to spend all morning editing this one because it's already after 8:30 and I have to wake up at about 4 tomorrow. So, until next time, this is the Clumsy Jedi signing off, telling everyone, may the Force be with you, always. Oh yeah, and one more thing. It's only 99 days until Force Friday when the Episode 8 merchandise gets released. Oh boy, I've missed that when I watched the...